In this module, you will learn how to create for loops in MATLAB. After you complete this module, you should be able to write and use for loops. You should also know when to use a nested for loop instead of a single for loop. The contents of this module assume that you know how to use mathematical, logical, and relational operators in MATLAB, know how to create flowcharts for planning your MATLAB code, know how to use selection structures in MATLAB, and know how to use the fprintf command. MATLAB has two types of loops, for loops and while loops. For loops execute a specific number of times. This type of loop is known as a definite loop because the number of iterations is known. While loops are loops that execute until a specified condition is met. This type of loop is known as an indefinite loop because the number of iterations is not known. This module focuses on for loops. A for loop has a structure shown here. It begins with the word for, which is followed by an index variable. The index variable is a vector or matrix of values. Between the for and end statements is one or more lines of code. To execute the for loop the first time, MATLAB uses the first value of the index variable. For the next pass, the next value of the index variable is used. This process repeats until all the values have been used. Therefore, the final value of the index is the final value in the vector or matrix. Here you can see the output of the for loop. To visualize how for loops work, we can represent the loop as a flowchart. To begin, any variables or statements are initialized. Then, the index variable is initialized with a start value, which is the first value in the vector or matrix. For the next step, MATLAB executes the block of code in the for loop continuously for all values in the index variable. The loop terminates after the code has been executed for the last value of the index variable. After the last pass, MATLAB exits the loop and continues with the rest of the program. Let's look at some examples. For the first loop, we will simply print the index value to the command window for each iteration of the loop. In each of these examples, the index variable is called index, although it could be any reasonable name. The index variable is a vector with three elements, so the loop will iterate three times with index values of 1, 3, and 7. We now run the code to view the results. In the second loop, the index variable is again named index and is a vector of length 4 with values of 1, 3, 5, and 7. Instead of simply printing the value of the index to the command window, we will use an fprintf command to properly format the output. Also, we include an fprintf command outside the loop. This way, we can verify the value of the index variable once the for loop has terminated. We now run the code to view the results. Notice that m equals 7 is printed twice, as the index retains its last value when it exits the for loop. In the third for loop, we will create a vector a by adding a new element to the vector during each pass of the for loop. The value of each additional element of a is 3 times the index value. When we run the code, we see the final output a is a vector of length 3 with values of 3, 6, and 9. Let's look at a more complex example related to exam scores. In this example, we will calculate an exam average for 3 exams. Given is a vector called examInfo. This vector includes the student's ID number and their scores from 3 exams. There are many methods we could use to calculate the exam average. Here we will use for loops. First, we create the vector exam info in the input section. Another variable called exam total is initialized at 0. This variable stores the cumulative total for all the exams. The index variable of the for loop will be used to cycle through the 3 exam scores. Through each iteration of the loop, the indexed exam score is added to the cumulative score of the previous exams. After exiting the loop, the exam average is calculated. This average is then displayed alongside with the student's ID number using an fprintf statement. When we run the script, we see that the exam total score grows with each pass. Then, once the loop is complete, the formatted output prints to the command window. In the previous example, we calculated an exam average for one student. Now we will calculate the exam average for 5 students. Each row in the matrix shown here contains exam information for a separate student. To calculate the exam average given this matrix, we need 2 for loops, one to calculate the exam average for each student and one to iterate through the list of students. This technique of placing one loop within another is called a nested loop. At the top of the code, you will see the variable examInfo, which contains the scores for 5 students. The for loop code from the previous example is shown here, but we must add a second loop to iterate through each student's data. To do this, we must first use the size command to obtain the size of the examInfo matrix, so we know the number of students we have data for. Using this command instead of a hard-coded value allows the code to adapt to matrices of various sizes. With the number of rows or students now known, we need to add the second for loop around the existing code. This for loop will be indexed from 1 to the number of students in the matrix. Finally, 2 changes must be made to account for use of multiple students. Change the element referencing in the exam total calculation and the fprintf statement to account for the matrix of data. The rest of the code from the previous example remains the same. Effectively, this code now uses 2 for loops nested within each other. The outer loop iterates on the individual students, while the inner loop iterates through the exam scores of each student. When we run this code from the command window, we see 5 statements printed to the command window, each representing the ID number and exam average for each student. Now that you have completed this module, you should be able to write and use for loops. You should also know when to use a nested for loop instead of a single for loop. This module covers only some of the concepts on this topic. For additional information, refer to other available sources. Also, remember that you can view this module at any time and as many times as you desire.